For a blue bag, what would it be for 99? Got to raise your hand so I know. Yes.
10,081.
10,081. No.
9,000.
Yes.
9,501.
9,501. No.
9,801.
She says 9,801. Let's see. The difference between the given number and 100 is 1. We do two things with the 1, like we did over here. The first thing we do with the 1 is we subtract it from the given number. 1 from 99 is 98. The second thing we do with the 1 is square it. 0, 1. 9,801, you are left holding the bag. Can you catch it? Thank you. And all of a sudden, the prizes are deteriorating rather quickly. Okay. Once again, with the 96, the little number would be a 4. So we subtract 4 from 96, and then we square the 4. Okay? Now, to stay on time, I'm going to have to skip the 80s, but I can tell you that there's a shortcut method for squaring numbers in the 80s, in the 70s, in the 60s, in the 30s. There's no shortcut for squaring numbers in the 20s or in the teens, and that is why I told you a little bit earlier that one of the requirements for speed math is that you should, for sure, memorize the squares of two-digit numbers up to 30. Because beyond 30, there's a shortcut method for every one of them, depending on what decade they fall in. Now, some people might say this, oh, are you telling me that, okay, fine, I'm going to memorize the two-digit squares up to 30, and you're telling me I'm going to have to learn this method for numbers in the 30s and another one for the 40s, 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s. That's an awful lot for me to memorize. First of all, it's fun. You're going to want to do it. But let me take your side. You say, hey, that's too much to memorize. Okay, fine. Then let's not do a specific or a specialized method of squaring. Let's instead look at a generalized method, a method that will work for every single two-digit number, whether that number is 10 or whether it's 99. And it looks like this. Just three steps. We square the units digit. Secondly, we multiply the tens digit times the units digit times 2. And finally, we square the tens digit. Now, if we relate that to a specific example, it'll become very clear. Let's pick a number. Let's do an easy one first. Let's pick 43. We want to square 43. Now, when we finish with step 1, we're going to have the digit of the answer that's furthest to the right. In other words, the units digit. Here's what I mean. Square the units digit. Well, here's the units digit, 3. 3 squared is 9. That's going to be the far right digit. Next, multiply the tens digit times the units digit times 2. 4 times 3 is 12, times 2 is 24. 24, right down to 4, carry the 2. Last step, square the tens digit. When I square the 4, I get 16, and the 2 I carry is 18, 1849. I'm finished. Incidentally, before I do another example of this, at the end of the second step, I had to carry a 2. And I don't know if you noticed me, I said, what was it, 24, I said, we write down a 4 and carry a 2. I did this. That was not by accident. I told you I was dumb as a stick, and I'll prove it right now. I have trouble remembering what I'm carrying, okay? Now, I don't believe in adding on my fingers, but I think it's very convenient that we all have 5 fingers on each hand because they can help us to remember a particular digit that we're carrying. And here's what I mean. Anytime I want to remember 1, I do this, or a 2, or a 3, or a 4, or a 5. That's obvious. Now, to remember 6, I don't want to do this because I might need this hand for another digit later on. So I'd like to be able to remember a 6, 7, 8, 9, or 0 on the same hand. So what I do is, once we get beyond 5, when I want to remember a 6, I do this. I touch the thumb to the forefinger. That's my 6. A 7 is to the middle finger. An 8 is to the ring finger. A 9 is for the a 9 would be touching the thumb to the little finger. And if I want to remember a 0, I use a closed fist. I don't use this for 0 because that would be my 6. And there's always somebody who seems to remind me, hey, wait a second, you got it backwards. And I say, what are you talking about, have it backwards? They say, do you know sign language? I say, no. And somebody told me a long time ago, they say in sign language, I guess, a 6, this is a 6. It's the very opposite of what I came up with. I just came up with this on my own. But they use this for a 6, this for a 7, this for an 8, this for a 9. I don't even know what they use for a 0. But, oh, what is it?
This is 10.
Yeah, but what if it's just a 0, not a 10? Aha! You're going to have to work on that. I'd love to know the answer to that. Oh, and then we've got the other hand to remember another digit. So in this problem, I had to carry a 2, so I did this. But if I had to carry, let's say, an 8, I would do this. And then later, I'd take a look. Oh, and I'm carrying an 8. Okay, and I would add it on. Let's do a tough one. Let's do, hey, I tell you what. Let's do the toughest one possible. Let's do 99. Now, before we even do 99, you're going to be presented with a choice to make pretty soon. As soon as you get this method down, the next time you have to square 99, you're going to say, wait a second. He showed me a specialized method for squaring a number that begins with a 9. You know how it's done, right? You got the 99, right? But on the other hand, you're going to say to yourself, well, on the other hand, he also showed me a 3-step method whereby I can square any 2-digit number, including 99. Which one of those two should I use to determine what the square of 99 is? The answer is, use whichever method you feel you can come up with more quickly. I think in the case of 99, though, we'd all agree, when you're finished seeing this, that'll be the method that you just learned a little while ago. But let's suppose we didn't know that method. We're relying strictly on the generalized method. Here we go. 9 squared is 81. Write down to 1, carry the 8. Second step, multiply the tens digit times the units digit times 2. Oh, and incidentally, she's speaking at another session. I mentioned that to you because I don't want to see a mad rush of people going out the door, you see. She told me that she was going to have to leave. Anyway, okay, so step 2, we multiply the tens digit times the units digit, 81. We double 81. We have to do that in our heads, 81 times 2 or 81 plus 81, whichever way you want to think of it, 162. 162, but we're carrying 8, that's 170. There's the 0, and I have to carry the 17, carrying 17. Last step, square the tens digit. 9 squared is 81, and we're carrying 17. 81 plus 10 plus 7 is 98. A lot of work, but that's a tough problem. Okay, but that's the way you square any 2-digit number. So if we just did one more, let's do 57, and you know how to do that one already too, because it begins with a 5. But if you didn't know that method, we'd say 7 squared is 49. Write down the 9, carry a 4. Multiply 5 times 7 times 2. That's 35 doubled is 70. And the 4 we carry is 74. Carry a 7. Last step, 5 squared is 25. 25 plus the 7 is 32. And we're finished. Okay? Any questions about that method? Okay. Wow, we got to go. In doing squaring and multiplication, I'm leaving out squaring 3-digit numbers. Yes, there is a method. It involves 5 steps. And for those of you who are real eager beavers, yes, there's a method for 4-digit squaring as well, okay? 7 steps. I'm not trying to tell you that if you use this method on a 4-digit square, that you're going to get the answer faster than you would with a calculator. No, you wouldn't. Fortunately, we don't have to square 4-digit numbers all that often. But I will tell you this, once you learn this method, you'll be able to square a 4-digit number faster than if you were to take 2,132 and stick it under each other, you know, with the line and all the numbers. We don't want to do all those numbers anymore. Okay, let's do a little something on multiplication. Recently, there was a news article about 3 schools in New Jersey that were at odds with each other because the superintendent's office found out that the three schools under his jurisdiction were all using different math textbook series. And so he went to them and he says, I want the three of you schools to get together and just pick one of your math book series to go with. We don't want three different math book series in our district. Well, the three schools couldn't get together. They were very adamant about the particular math books that they were using. Well, the reporter says, the reason they were so adamant is because each one of them really loved the way computation was taught in their textbook. This is what they had. The first school used a textbook series that taught multiplication this way, which basically is the way I learned way back when. It works. Chances are most of you learned using that method. But I don't like it anymore. I think it's too slow. Too much writing also. The second school used this method. Same problem. They want to make sure the kids understand where all these numbers come from. So they said, well, you know, 12 times 25, that takes in 20 times 10, which is 200, 20 times 2, which is 40, 10 times 5, which is 50, and 5 times 2, which is 10. We add those up, we get 300. They're telling their students every single time you multiply a pair of two-digit numbers together, we want to see all these numbers written here. Think that's what the kids from Singapore do in this case? I don't think so. Well, I was really getting annoyed watching this, and I thought to myself, what in the world are they teaching these kids? It's taking them so long to get to answers. And I thought, what in the world could the third method be? Well, the third method threw me. I had never seen the third method before, and I hope I never see it again. Looks like this. It's called matrix multiplication, as perhaps some of you know. There's the 12 up there, the 25 here. 2 times 2 is 0, 4. 2 times 1 is 0, 2. 5 times 2 is 1, 0. 5 times 1 is 0, 5. You have all these lines, and some teachers might require that you use different color Crayola for each line, and positively use the ruler, of course. And so you finally, you know, you add up these numbers. There's a 0. This is 10. Carry a 1. 2 plus 1 is 3, and 0. So there's your answer, 300. So all of our scientists and engineers, this is the way they multiply 12 times 25. That's what the kids are told. You do this every time you're multiplying 12 times 25 or any pair of two-digit numbers. In the meantime, I'm looking at the TV screen and I'm saying, where is my method? Here's my method. You just put down the answer. Now, I don't want you to say, oh, sure, 12 times 25. You see, 25 fits into 100 four times, and 4 goes into 12 3 times 100 or whatever. No, it's got nothing to do with the actual numbers of 12 or 25.